He holds a doctorate degree in mass communication and journalism from the University of Mysore. He has board of director for International Network of Quality Assurance Agency in Higher Education from 2013 to 15, which is worldwide association for over 200 organizations of quality assurance agencies. He has authored few books on IQAC, with today's topic on NAC preparation, IQAC, and submission of self-study report. I now invite Dr. Hegde to take over the session. Please, sir.
Thank you, madam, for introducing me to the audience. I'll just share my screen with you. Hope screen is visible for you.
Yes, sir, it's visible.
Hope it is audible.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir, it is audible.
Thank you, madam. Thank you very much for giving an opportunity to share some of the things with respect to the assessment and accreditation with you. I just would like to take the blessings of the Guru. Om Brahmanandam Paramasukadam Kevalam Jnanamurtim Dvandvatitam Gaganasadrisham Tattvamasyadilakshanam Ekam Nityam Vimalamachalam Sarvasa Sarvadi Sakshi Bhutam Bhavatitam Trigunarahitam Sadgurum Tam Namami O. My respect to all the teachers who are viewing this webinar on behalf of the NAC and on behalf of the Anand Pharmacy College, I welcome you all for this webinar. Our director, Professor S.C. Sharmaji, has sent a special message to the college for organizing this webinar in collaboration with the NAC. As you all know that any good work comes with some of the warm-up. Today's webinar is one of such activities. If we have to succeed in the life, unless you make a good preparation, you will not be able to succeed. The English proverb says, if you have done a good beginning, then half done. In the similar way, if you have done a good work at the institutional level, I think your work is in a success. As you all know that, whether it is a 100 meter relay or a 400 into 400 meter relay, or it may be the marathon running, it needs a lot of preparation. Today's webinar is one such activity in towards achieving the goal. The goal is how to achieve the highest thing in the education. Today, the Anand Pharmacy College is organizing this webinar, which is part of the Sardar Patel University. The NAC vision has stated in the MOUs of the NAC. It states, to make the quality as the defining element of higher education in India through a combination of self and external quality evaluation, promotion and sustenance initiative. The Anand Pharmacy College also will be having such activity or such vision statement, as our president, Dr. Hemant Bhai Patel ji and Dr. Jyotsna Ben Patel has already spelled out some of the activities of the management. When a management is looking about how the things has to be go ahead with the vision statement, it should be short, it should be simple, and it should be specific to the institution. If it is a pharmacy, it should be pharmaceutical chemistry, pharmaceutical pharmacognosy, or quality assurance, or even an extension program which you will be having at the institutional level. The mission statement of the NAC, which I would like to share with you, to make the stimulating the academic environment in the higher education institution, encouraging the self-evaluation, accountability, autonomy, and undertaking the quality related research studies and collaborating with the other stakeholders of the higher education institutions. The core value of the NAC is contributing to the national development, fostering the global competencies, inculcating the value system among the student, promoting the use of technology and quest for excellence. Each and every matrix of the NAC talks about this national development value system and also use of technology and also the quest for excellence. If you are doing the 1 to 4 from the contributing to the national development to the promoting use of technology, you will be achieving the quest for excellence. How it will be done? Through the NAC accreditation. While going through the NAC accreditation, our request is to look into the NAC website, download all the manual, guidelines, standard operating procedure, and also the data template, and also the student satisfaction survey questionnaire also, so that it will facilitate you to understand in a better sense what actually the NAC is looking for. Any institutions which are applying to the NAC should have a 6 years of standing or 2 batches of degree or a post-graduation degree should have come out from that particular institution. Kindly go through the NAC website where you will be able to get all the information which is related to the how to apply to the NAC. You can register in the NAC portal also. What is the registration? Any institutions which is accredited or not accredited also can register in the NAC portal. Registration is a must. If you wanted to ask any question to the NAC, then unless you register, you cannot ask any question to the NAC through the portal. Our request to the higher education institution is that kindly register in the NAC portal. For registration, 3 things are required. What is that one? MHRD AISHE certificate is required. Institution email ID is required, and also your 1 mobile number is required to register in the NAC portal. While registering to the NAC portal, what are all the documents you need for the assessment? One is the affiliation letter you need for a current academic year. That means the institutions which are affiliated. Suppose, for example, Anand Saraswati College is there. It has to apply to the NAC. Now, for that application, it should give the affiliating university letter stating that you are running the program which are all recognized by the affiliating university. Suppose if you are having a pharmacy, the pharmacy has to be recognized by the Pharmacy Council of India. So this council has to recognize some of the program. So whether you have taken an approval from the PCI, that also with the latest one has to be given to the NAC. The 4th one is that AISHE certificate is required. Jaisa college ke liye C se start hota hai, university ke liye U se start hota hai. So that number you have to give, and your certificate also should be given. Suppose if there is a change in the name of the AISHE certificate and the institution, then you have to give an undertaking stating that you will change the name in the next when you are submitting to the AISHE for the further. If at all you are going for the second and subsequent cycle, for example, 2nd cycle, 3rd cycle or 4th cycle in the institution, then you have to give the previous 5-year AQAR to the NAC. Undertaking by the higher education institution should be given, stating that you will be following the state government affiliating university and also the statutory regulatory authorities and UGC norms will be followed by the institution. Like that, you have to give one undertaking. And a self-declaration is also should be given. In the self-declaration, what is to be given is the computer IP address also should be given. What documents you will be uploading, those computer details also you have to give. For example, if you upload all the documents, it will come like that. These are the documents which you have applied or the uploaded in the institution and website and in the NAC portal. Then there is a verification process will be there at the NAC, and you will get it approved by the NAC. This is one of the things which is about to whomever it may concern, saying that one university will give you the declaration saying that this college has been recognized by the particular university. If you are having the UGC TELUBI, you can give. If it is without 2F and 12B also, NAC is taking up the assessment. But the AISHE code and submission of the AICC document is more important. Without that, it will not be processed for further for the NAC accreditation. Subsequent cycle institution, for example, Anand Pharmacy College. These colleges has to, when the validity period is ending, for example, let us say May 2020-21, your validity period ends. So before the May 21st, 2020-21, your application should be pending with the NAC. That means the last 6 months will be from January to the May. So within that 5 months, anytime you have to apply to the NAC for the continuation of the accreditation validity period. Now, our request to the institution is that kindly make one icon in the institutional website. Suppose if the Anand Pharmacy College is undergoing for the accreditation, let us say after 2 years, they will be going for accreditation. Now, within these 2 years, you kindly create an icon in the institutional website. Under that one, IQAC. Under that one, kindly upload all the AQAR certificates, grade sheet, and also all the informations in that particular icon, so that if you wanted to retrieve those information, it will be easy. Our to the institution is that, though it is a next after 6 months to the 1 year you are applying, but my request to institution is that kindly scan all the document, for example, syllabus, for example, academic calendar, the students' participation in various sports and games, teachers' participation in the various seminars and webinars. If you are conducted the webinar, then the video link. Suppose it's having the teaching learning process, then the photographs. Those things all should be documented in the institution. Those documented one, kindly upload in the institutional website and provide a what to call a password. But if you wanted to go for the accreditation during that period, kindly make sure that you will be removing the password. So this will help you to continuously upgrading yourself in the documentation process. Unless the document is very good, you will not be able to succeed with the highest one. So NAC has got the support help desk, wherein the institutions can ask the question to the NAC. Our director, Professor S.C. Sharma ji, has made this support help desk within 24 hours to the 48 hours. We will respond to your queries. There are 7 stages will be there at different level. So today I will be talking to you on the up to the manual and the guideline and the submission to the NAC. You will also need to refer the standard operating procedures, the DVV clarification, and also the student satisfaction survey, and also the online peer review will be there with the data validation and verification, and the qualitative metrics will be validated through the on-site visit. Now, timeline is more important. Einstein sometime back has said, everybody has got 24 hours. Dr. Kalpana Madam will be having 24 hours. Dr. Jyotsam Ben will be having the 24 hours. Dr. Hemant Bhai will also be having the 24 hours. Within 24 hours, we have to work. The UGC, the MHRD, the Niti Aayog, and the Prime Minister Office states that whole NAC process should be completed within 120 days to the 180 days. So that is a maximum time will be given to the institution. So considering that one, NAC has arrived at a 7-stage timeline process. Accurate within 15 days, SSR submission 45 days, DVV clarifications 21 days, the announcement of the DVV within 7 days, pre-qualification will be 7 days, and the peer team visit will be within 2 months. And finally, the calculation of the grade and the final declaration should be within 30 days. So full milakar jo hai, to 180 days mein iska accreditation ka kaam pura hona chahiye. This is what the institutions have been informed by the MHRD. So there are 62% depends upon the online evaluation, and 37% depends upon the on-site evaluation. There are 7 criteria are there: curricular, teaching, learning, extension, infrastructure and learning, student support and progression, governance, leadership and management, and institutional values and best practices. What are the key indicators which NAC introduced during the last 5 years? The NAC has introduced the student satisfaction survey, innovations ecosystem, alumni engagement, institutional values and social responsibilities, and institutional distinctiveness. So distinctiveness is that, suppose if there is an Anand Pharmacy College is there, there is a Mumbai, there is a one more college will be there. So those things, you will be able to make sure that you have a distinctive nature, which you would like to highlight during the accreditation process. So there are 115 metrics are there for the universities, for 107 for autonomous colleges, and 93 and metrics for the NPG colleges. In this whole chart, you will be able to see that one. And there are 37% depends upon the qualitative, and 62% depends upon the quantitative nature. So 35 metrics which comes as a qualitative, and 58 metrics comes as a quantitative nature. Further, I will be sharing with you that how it is further divided. My request to all institution is that every metrics is more important, whether it's a 2-mark question, whether it's a 4-mark question, whether it's a 5-mark question, whether it's a 10-mark question, it is more important. Kindly download all the templates, and also they upload the filled template in its appropriate metric in the SSR. There is an executive introductory note should be there. Suppose if there is a pharmacy college which is there in the Anand. Anand ka bare mein kuch likhna hai. University ka bare mein kuch likhna hai. And also the location and the vision and the mission of the institution should be given. And type of the institution, whether it is a pharmacy, whether it is a social work, whether it is a teacher education, whether it is a general arts, science, commerce college, or whether it is a women's college. So highlight your institution's strength in this criterion wise summary, and also the preface, and also highlight some of the strengths, weaknesses and opportunities and challenges also, because it will help the institution to give the good direction by the peer team members. So overall, there is a conclusive explanation may be given. So there is a extended profile is also there. What is an extended profile? Number of students, number of faculty, number of faculty having a PhD, number of classrooms, number of PhD holders in the institution. Like that, there are some numbers will be there. So our request to the institution is that extended profile you have to give properly in the SSR. That is more important, because it comes as a denominator for the calculation purpose. So I will quickly go through the some of the 7 criteria highlights here only. It's not maybe the too lengthy one, but it's just to give you the highlight how exactly NAC meticulously working out for the assessment and accreditation purpose with respect to the affiliated college. Now, curricular aspect, 100 mark will be there, weightage. This 100 weightage will be further divided into 20, 30, 30 and 20. Curriculum planning and implementation, academic flexibility, curriculum enrichment and feedback system. What actually the NAC is looking? NAC is looking about the effective curriculum delivery with a planned and documented process. Planned means whether you are having an academic calendar or not. If you are having an academic calendar, when the sports will be there, when the cultural activities will be there, when the pre-examination will be there, when the sudden stretch will be there, when the monthly test will be there, when the end semester examination will be there, those things will be planned in the institution. There is a documented process. Suppose if it is a project-based learning, how it will be done, whether it is a student have been given the internship, how exactly it has been done. So those need to be documented. If the syllabus has been revision, it has been done, and the process you have to give. So like that, the NAC is looking about the procedural part and the process part and the outcome part also in the assessment process. Now, if you look into the continuous internal evaluation, this is a QLM which will be evaluated by the peer team members during the on-site visit. Design and development of the curriculum and for the add-on and the certificate courses. Now, if you look into the design and development, how exactly your add-on courses are there, certificate courses are there, diploma courses are there, which NAC is looking. For the add-on courses and the diploma courses, you need the approval from the university. But for certificate course, for a small certificate course, you may create your own courses also. For example, if your pharmacy college is having, Anand Pharmacy College is starting a small certificate course on drug discovery, let us say. So it may have an approval from the affiliating university, Sardar Patel University, or it may have its own certificate, but it is also need to be have a small board of study has to approve this type of the certificate also. Choice-based credit system is more important. Elective course will be there as per the Pharmacy Council of India, whether you are having the Dr. Deepak Mehta ji, Dr. Deepak Mehta ji, kindly make it the unmute. Mute kariye, sir. The professional ethics, gender, human values, environmental sustainability into the curriculum is more important. What is required is that one, the professional ethics. If the pharmacy college is having, there must be some professional ethics will be there. A student and the teachers and also the if the outcome of the student has to have some of the professional ethics, gender, human values, and environmental sustainability, as per the Supreme Court order, you need to have some courses for the benefit of the student. Percentage of courses, project work, field work, internship is more important. When you look into the pharmacy as a thing, you will be having some project work, field work, and internship will be there. But how it is? Whether, suppose if I ask one question, Kalpana Madam, say my Pushu talk, Anand Pharmacy College, me, if you are having an internship, do you have an internship diary? How it will be done in the internship? So if this type of the things question will come when the assessment happens. So number of students undertaking that project work is more important. Curriculum enrichment, graduate employability is more important. As in the morning I told you, the graduates come from the Anand Pharmacy College should be proudly say that I am the student of Anand Pharmacy College. So then only it will be having a good stature in the academia as well as in the society. Feedback need to be collected, analyzed, and action taken report should be given to the NAC also. And you need to upload in the institutional website. That is more important. What is a course? What is a program? I will just share with you. A program is a BA, BSc, BCom, or a BPharm and MPharm will be the one which you will call as a program. Now, for a specific course is a one where there is number of credits will be there. It may be number of papers will be there. So for example, there are pharmaceutical chemistry, pharmacy, and also the chemistry, pharmaceutical chemistry will be there. So there are various papers will be there for the pharmacy. For the general thing, which I have brought it here, is the theory and the practice. A core course will be there. There is an elective will be there. As per the Pharmacy Council of India, you will be having your own program, which is approved by the Pharmacy Council of India and the affiliating university. There may be some core course will be there. There is a compulsory course will be there. There are in the pharmacy also, you can have the green chemistry. You can have industrial chemistry. You can have the instrumentation methods of analysis. You can have a dissertation. You can have a modeling. You can have the pharmaceutical chemistry with respect to the pesticide chemistry, fuel chemistry. You can have analytical chemistry. You can have business skills for the chemistry, you can have intellectual property, you can have, and these are all some of the skill enhancement courses which you can start at the institutional level. What do you mean by an value added course? What do you mean by an add-on courses? Add-on courses are the one which adds a value to the program. Suppose a pharmacy student is taking the industrial psychology, let us say. So it will be an add-on courses which adds a value to the program. TV production is another thing which you can look into it. Value-added courses are the which is particular for the individual to develop their the skills in their chosen field of study. That means it may be marketing, it may be capital market, or it may be lab training, or it may be the .NET and visual. If the pharmacy student wants to look into those value-added courses, you can start. But it should have more than 30 contact hours. Then only it will be considered as the certificate course or add-on course. Add-on courses should have the affiliating university approval. But certificate course, you may have your own certificate course. All the pharmacy colleges will come under the general mandate. Earlier, NAC has made, say, some time, the pharmacy will come under the medical. But now it has been published in the NAC website stating that all pharmacy colleges will come under the general college manual only. Kindly contextualize your institution according to the questions which NAC has made, and contextualizing the pharmacy college, kindly write the answer in the NAC manual. In 1.3.1 talks about the qualitative metrics. For example, there is a 10 weightage is there. 1.3.2 talks about the average percentage of the courses that include the experiential learning through the project work, field work, and internship during the last 5 years. 1.3.3 talks about the percentage of student undertaking the project work, field work, internship, and the student internship is also important, and student project also will be taking up for the validation purpose. How exactly the NAC calculates? For example, in the 1.3 curriculum enrichment, there is a 30 weightage is there. So in the 30 weightage, 1.3.1, 1.3.2, 1.3.3, there are 10 weightages are there. How it will be calculated? Hypothetically, I have put on a 0 to 4 scale. If you validate that one in a 0 to 4 scale, hypothetically, I have put 2, 3 and 2. Now, the 10 into 2, you will get 20. 10 into 4, you may get the 40. 10 into 2, you will get the 20. 10 into 1, you will get the 10. So depending upon the weightage which you are giving, it will be multiplied. So my request to the institution is that all the system generated score is having the benchmark. The benchmark is not publicly available, which is a self-confidential document at the NAC. Maximum one can get in this particular metric is 30 into 4, they will get the 120. But institution has got 70 in this particular key indicator. I just would like to share you one thing. Mathematics may not teach us how to add happiness or how to minus the sadness, but it does teach one important thing. Every problem has got a solution. Every problem which you are facing in the institution will have one or the other way, there is a solution will be there. A teaching learning evaluation, there is a 350 weightage will be there out of the 1,000. It is further divided into 7 key indicators. Student enrollment and profile, catering to student diversity, teaching learning process, teacher profile and quality, evaluation process and reforms, student performance and learning outcome, and student satisfaction survey. What actually the NAC is looking is the student to full-time teacher. Who is the full-time teacher? A full-time teacher is the one who teaches the 90% of the workload of a regular teacher, and his appointment should be there for 1 year, will be called as a full-time teacher. ICT-enabled tools for effective teaching learning during this COVID-19. Many teachers have switched over to the ICT-enabled tools, but how many tools you are having, that is also more important. Whether it is maybe Swayam portal, whether it is a MOOCs portal, whether it is a online resources or the e-databases, how exactly you are having that, you can look into it. Ratio of mentor to mentee, that is the mentor to student, is another thing. Average percentage of the full-time teachers against the sanctioned post, full-time teachers with a PhD, program courses, course outcome, attainment of the program outcomes. These are some of the things are required. Final year project mentored, evaluated by the externals. Professionals is more important. आविष्कार हो, अन्वेषण हो, नवाचार हो, उसका बारे में आपको सोचना चाहिए. Always we say that one. Great teachers never try to be the best teachers. They simply try to bring out the best in the students. A teaching learning process has to have an impact with the Bloom's taxonomy. And I feel that there must be an accreditation taxonomy should be there. And this Bloom taxonomy can be further divided into the e-learning, teaching, ICT enabled teaching, brainstorming, group learning, live demo, web resources, peer teaching, activity-based learning, and also the regular review of the journals by the teachers. For example, just to give you a hypothetical example here, is that the peer assessment will come with the 2.3.1, 2.3.2. But whereas 2.3.3 looks about the system generated score. Hypothetically, I have put on a 0 to 4 scale, this like this way. So maximum they can get is the 200, but the institution has got the 115. My request to the Dr. Kalpana Patel Madam, Dr. Jyotsna Patel Madam, and Dr. Gandhi, and also the Dr. Hemant Bhai is that, kindly make sure that in your institution, you can work out in this way. So before you are going for accreditation, you will be able to assess about yourself only. NAC has got the peer assessment and the system generated score. Peer assessment will be for the qualitative, and system generated score will be for the DVV process. Some people want the things to happen. Some people wish it could have happened, but some people will take lead and make it to happen. So my सोचता हूँ उनके लिए सवेरे नहीं होते जो जिंदगी में कुछ भी पाने के उम्मीद छोड़ चुके हैं. उजाला तो उनका होता है जो बार बार हारने के बाद कुछ भी पाने के लिए उम्मीद रखते हैं. इन द रिसर्च एंड इनोवेशन एंड एक्सटेंशन देर आर 5 की इंडिकेटर्स आर देर. रिसर्च मोबिलाइजेशन, रिसोर्स मोबिलाइजेशन एंड रिसर्च, इनोवेशन इकोसिस्टम, रिसर्च पब्लिकेशन अवार्ड्स, एक्सटेंशन एक्टिविटी एंड कोलैबोरेशन. सो देर इज अ स्लाइट डिफरेंस बिटवीन द यूजी कॉलेज एंड पीजी कॉलेज. Further details, you can look into the NAC manual also. Intellectual property right, grants received, percentage of the department having research project, number of research papers per teacher, number of papers written in the refereed journals, books and chapters, extension activity, number of paper published, number of awards and recognition, number of extension activities, number of functional MOUs with the national and international institutions, student participating in extension activity such as Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, etc. That is more important. What we require is that innovations is more important. Think differently and act positively should be the slogan for the institutions. So there is an Atal Innovations Mission is available. You can look into the various things in the Atal Innovations Mission. And in this Atal Innovation Mission, in the, under the Niti Aayog, you will be having various programs and the incubation centers. Kindly go through this Atal Innovation Mission, which is there in the MHRD website. You can look into it and kindly be the part of this Atal Community Innovation Center. You can look into the Government of India, Niti Aayog. There are several institutions have got the grant in aid by the MHRD also. There is a National Innovation Context will be there, and there is an MHRD Innovation Cell will be there. And if with your help only, Atal ranking for institutions have been done, and India would like to promote this innovations ecosystem through the higher education institution, so that in the coming year, the India should take a lead in terms of the innovations in higher education institutions. So there is a design and thinking process, there is a technology transfer, Made in India program, Make in India program, Stand Up India program, Startup India program, Digital India program, Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, and Unnat Bharat Abhiyan. And there is a new thing which is coming, is the STRIDE. So kindly look into the UGC as well as the MHRD site for this purpose. This is a small photo which will convey the meaning that local and the local person can think differently, having the new knowledge which is component, and they will make a life differently. Why can't our teachers can think differently and act positively? Where there is a will, there is a way. This session, the resource mobilization and research, has got a 15 mark. The 15 mark, how it will be done? The 15 mark in 0 to 4, if you scale, if you make it, then maximum one can get is a 60. But the institution has got a 40. My request to institution is that the whatever the questions are there, in the third criteria, particularly just to tell you, in the third key aspect of that criteria, research, innovations, and extension, most of the things will be quantitative. Kindly focus on the quantitative nature here. Qualitative is very, very less. So kindly look into the, you can, our request to the institution is that the system generated score can come up like this. Coffee never knew that it would taste so nice and sweet. Before it met milk and sugar, we are good at my session. The coffee never knew it would taste so nice and sweet before it met with the sugar and milk. We are good at as an individual, but we should become better when we met and the blend with the right type of the people. Infrastructure and learning resources, physical facilities, library as a learning resources, IT infrastructure, maintenance of the campus is another thing. ICT enabled service, Shodh Ganga, Shodh Sindhu, e-resources, outdoor gymnasium, yoga center, annual expenditure of the purchase of the books, IT facilities, student computer ratio, average expenditure, dynamic institutional website, maintenance of the campus, full-fledged ICT and digital connectivity, library space, books, journals, periodicals, open access, internet, digital e-library, ensuring the full utilization of the infrastructure. Finally, it is a cleanliness is more important. Student support and progression. There are four key indicators are there: student support, student progression, student participation and activities, and alumni engagement. So free ship provided by government, capacity building of the student, skill enhancement, like soft skill, language skill, communication, life skills, yoga, physical fitness, health and hygiene, ICT and computing facilities, remedial coaching, yoga and meditation, personal counseling, placement of the student, alumni association and alumni contribution. My request to the institution, to the Anand Pharmacy College and all other participants who are viewing this webinar is that alumni is the greatest source. So kindly make this incubation center in collaboration with the alumni. Suppose if there is an old student who is a manager, who is in a senior position, you can take him the 10,000 or 20,000 and make a room as an incubation center. And 10 by 10 room you make it. And on that room, kindly share that one and make a good, what to call a slogan, the things. And within 6 months, you may not be able to get much of the things. But after 6 months, I am sure that your student and the teachers, if they join together, they can make a good incubation centers. Incubation can center lead to the new startup at the institutional level. There is a governance and leadership and management, institutional vision, leadership, strategy development and deployment, faculty empowerment strategies, financial management and resource mobilization. Internal quality assurance system, these are all the five key indicators are there. Further, it is divided into the perspective plan, strategic plan, e-governance, financial support, effectiveness, and faculty development programs, orientation and refresher courses, short-term courses. My request to the institution is that IQAC is nothing but physically fit, mentally alert. Unless you are physically fit, you will not be able to make a 45 minutes to the 50 minutes lecture. मैं सोचता हूँ whether it is a yoga, meditation, ध्यानावस्थित हो सकता है और it may be the what you call bhastrika or pranayam which you will be having. These are all lead to the your self realization. मैं सोचता हूँ सर्वे संतु भवनः, सर्वे भवन्तु सुखिनः, सर्वे सन्तु निरामयः सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु मा कश्चित् दुःख भाग् भवेत् ओम शांतिः 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 एंड फिजिकल फिटनेस इज मोर इम्पोर्टेंट अनलेस यू आर फिजिकली फिट यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू मेक वर्क सो दी गवर्नेंस एंड लीडरशिप यू नीड टू हैव द इंस्टीट्यूशनल स्ट्रेटजीज लर्निंग आउटकम्स लीगल मैटर्स इंक्रीमेंटल इंप्रूवमेंट्स very well you will not be able to get a score high if you wanted to then your documentation should speak how the documentation will be done through the IQAC internal quality assurance cell need to make the documentation process may have 1 2 3 4 to 7 criteria and documentation only shows how methodical you are another college says like this way And somebody said, "What is a GDP? GDP is nothing but good documentation practice." Somebody said, "If you have not done good documentation of an activity, means that you have not done it." So the last criteria is about the institutional values and best practices, institutional values and social responsibility, best practices and institutional distinctiveness. These are the three key indicators are there. Renewable energy, rainwater harvesting, green initiatives, solid waste management, liquid waste management, biomedical, e-waste. Now in the Anand Pharmacy College, if you are having this some batteries or unused, wanted to throw in some place, then in the one basket, you put as a e-waste, then put all the student, you make a awareness that if you wanted to throw any electronic item, kindly throw here. So this will make most of the things. And in the institution also, rainwater harvesting and borewell recharging is also more important. So finally, I would like to share with you that stay committed to your decisions, but stay flexible in your approach. So flexibility is also more important. Lastly, you need to make the code of handbook. If you are tell that one, no, sir, we are doing a very, very good job. If you are having the good job, kindly make it as a handbook. Anand Pharmacy, you are doing. So that will help you to make sure that your student will be following, your teachers will be following, your governing body will be following, and those things you can look into it. And also the campus should be Divyang Jan friendly campus. And lastly, I would like to share with you that umr thaka nahi sakti, thokar gir nahi sakti, agar jeetne ka jeet ho to paristhitiya hara nahi sakti, keep on doing the good things. Because the institutional distinctiveness is more important. What is the distinctiveness? Every institution will have one or the other way. What is your good that you have to highlight in the best practices as well as in the institutional distinctiveness. For example, just to give you the Anand Pharmacy College. Let us say in the two areas, they are very good. One is drug discovery and second thing is the quality assurance. On these two fronts, how exactly the institution has made the improvement, achievement, and also the student progression, and also the teacher's achievement, you have to highlight. That will be the institutional best practices, and also the distinctiveness will be there. There is an optional metric will be there for the colleges. Maximum up to 30 weightage you can opt out, and criteria. Criteria 1 and criteria 7 you cannot opt out. Only in the criteria 3, 4, 5, 6 you can opt out. Maximum is only the 10 weightage for the each criteria. Maximum 3% or the 10 weightage will be taken for the optional metrics. You can go through the NAC. Lastly, I would like to tell you a small cartoon which I would like to share with you that what is the DVV? DVV is nothing but suppose Anand se aap Ahmedabad jana chahte hain, to aap train mein pakad gaya, ट्रेन पकड़ने के बाद आपने ऑनलाइन टिकटिंग किया था, ऑनलाइन टिकट करने के बाद टीसी आपसे पूछेंगे आप टिकट दे दीजिए, आप टिकट देने के बाद वो पूछेंगे आपका आईडी कार्ड कहाँ है, जब आप तक आप आईडी कार्ड नहीं दिखाएंगे तब आप ट्रेवल नहीं कर सकते। वैसे ही द इंस्टीट्यूशन इज आस्किंग द ड्यूरिंग द डीवीवी प्रोसेस इफ यू आर नॉट गिवन द डॉक्यूमेंट्स प्रॉपरली द डीवीवी विल आस्क द क्लैरिफिकेशन, दोज क्लैरिफिकेशन शुड बी गिवन इन द NAC portal only. For example, just to give you example, there are 50 teachers are there in the institution. You must have told those thing. You have given only 48 people's the PhD certificate. Now two certificate you are not given. Those certificate if you wanted to give, then your bridge will be completed. Otherwise, the gap will be there. So our request to the institution is that. Kindly provide the documentary evidence to the NAC. There are positive deviation, there is a negative deviation, there is a less deviation, there is a no deviation. My colleague, Dr. A.V. Prasad, will be talking to you on the DVV process. My colleague, Dr. Devendra Ji, will be talking to you on the data validation and verification process. अंत में मैं इतना बताना चाहता हूँ, लहरें से डरकर नौका पार नहीं होती, कोशिश करने वालों को हार नहीं होती। हरिवंश राय बच्चन जी ने बहुत अच्छा तरह से ये लाइन लिखा है, असफलता एक चुनौती है, स्वीकार करो, क्या कमी रह गई है देखो और सुधार करो, जब तक न सफल हो नींद चैन को त्यागो तुम, संघर्ष का मैदान छोड़ मत भागो तुम, कुछ किए बिना जय जयकार नहीं होती, कोशिश करने वालों को हार नहीं होती। आप कोशिश करते रहिए, आप सबको आभार प्रकट करता हूँ, धन्यवाद करता प्रकट करता हूँ और खास तौर पर आनंद फार्मेसी कॉलेज को बधाई देता हूँ, और मैं प्रोफेसर शिरीष कुलकर्णी जी को और डॉक्टर हेमंत भाई पटेल साहब को नमन करता हूँ, और मेरा प्रेजेंटेशन का अंत करने के लिए मैं आपसे विनती चाहता हूँ, वाणी को विराम देना चाहता हूँ, धन्यवाद, आभार।
Thank you, sir.
Over to host.
Thank you, sir, for such an informative session. It was indeed very, very informative pertaining to all the criteria and what are the requirements. Also, the importance of documentation and why it should be maintained. So, once again, big thanks from our side for such a wonderful session. Now, the session is of question and answer. Kalika, ma'am.
Yeah, ma'am. Yeah, sir. I have one question. Hello.
Yes.
Hello.
Bataye sir.
Sir, if a research paper having a two affiliated institutes, okay, whether it can be counted for both the institute or only first institute?
Only first institute.
Only first institute.
Yes, sir. और खास तौर पर जो पीजी के लिए जो क्वेश्चन है 3.4.5 और 3.4.3 जो भी है ना, उसमें ज्यादा तरह से हम पीजी कॉलेज को इन्फ्लिपनेट का डाटा ले लेंगे।
ओके सर, लेकिन नहीं, मेरा क्वेश्चन ये है, इंस्टीट्यूट ठीक है, यूनिवर्सिटी में देयर आर 7 इंस्टीट्यूट इज देयर, बट मैं ये बोलना चाहता हूँ कि अगर यहाँ की फार्मेसी कॉलेज, जैसे कि कोई यूनिवर्सिटी है उसकी फार्मेसी कॉलेज एंड दूसरी यूनिवर्सिटी है उसका एक फार्मेसी कॉलेज के साथ अगर एफिलिएटेड करके पेपर पब्लिश करते हैं, फर्स्ट ऑथर इज यूनिवर्सिटी बी और माय कॉलेज इज यूनिवर्सिटी, हाँ, तो दोनों में काउंट हो सकता है या एक में काउंट हो सकता है?
एक में काउंट, जो पहला सर, एज यू नो दैट एच इंडेक्स विल बी काउंटेड इन द फर्स्ट ऑथर ओनली, है ना, फर्स्ट ऑथर को जैसे आपको प्रमोशन में जैसा होता है, सो द फर्स्ट ऑथर विल गेट द मैक्सिमम वन सर।
Okay, and sir, second question is there, how to calculate the H index of the institute? If my college has, or university has 30 faculty, right? Out of 30, only 20 has H index, one or two more. 10 mein nahi hai, 10 faculty ko H index zero hai, because it's recent join hai, ya new joining hai, etc. So when we get the average, divide by 30 or 20?
Nahin, hum kya kar rahe hai idhar? Most of the data which is related to the research, number of publications, whether it is a PubMed, whether it is a Scopus, whether it is a UGC recognized journals, whichever we are telling. Na? Those things will be counted to the InfibNet. Jo data hai, wo hum maximum will count from the InfibNet data.
Yeah, I know, sir. Yeah, yeah, sir. I know, sir.
Once, and second thing is how it will be calculated. Sometimes the institutions are registered under the Scopus. Sometimes the institutions' names will be recognized in the PubMed. And those things will be considered from the their respective databases. NAC will use those databases of the different international databases, sir. The H index will depend upon, sometimes it is a Hirsch index. Sometimes it is on the person to person also they will calculate how many times your paper will be quoted. In some times the institution name will not be there. At that time, individual name will be counted.
In formula, in the manual, the formula is the H index of the institute is the H index of the Scopus plus H index of science in last 5 years divided by 2. So my question is there, H index of the Scopus or Web of Science?
Both will be taken into consideration.
Both will be, like out of 30 faculty, only 20 having H index, sir. 10 is the average is 200 of the H index of the 20 faculty. So divided by 30 or divided by 20 is okay.
No, divided by 30 will be there because we are doing the institutional accreditation. Institutional accreditation, how many faculty are there? 30 faculty mein, 20 faculty is researcher jo paper likh raha hai, hai na? Another 10, they may not be writing or their paper may not be that high standard, let us say. Hai na? So now, for the calculation purpose, it is a 30.
Yeah. Okay, sir, one more question is there. So in value-added courses, the 1.3.2 in the health manual, 1.3.2,
sir, pharmacy ke liye health science manual nahi hai. Pharmacy ke liye affiliated college manual hai.
No, sir, mental of the health science for the university, sir. I belong to the university, health science university.
Sir, aapka shubh naam?
डॉक्टर राजेश महेश्वरी सर,
राजेश महेश्वरी. मैं आपको एक निवेदन करता हूं, आज मैंने जो प्रेजेंटेशन दिया हूं वो कॉलेज के लिए है ना. आनंद फार्मेसी कॉलेज, आप आज जो भेजा, ये जो वेबिनार किया है वो कॉलेज के लिए है. हाँ, मैं आपका प्रश्न के लिए आंसर देता हूं, मगर ये आज का जो कार्यक्रम है ये कॉलेज के लिए है ना.
डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फार्मेसी संबंधी विद्यापीठ.
संदीप
विद्यापीठ,
बोलिए
सर. एक लास्ट क्वेश्चन ये है, इन प्लेसमेंट 5.2.2, इन प्लेसमेंट एंड सेल्फ एम्प्लॉयड ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स, तो उसके लिए वी रिक्वायर द प्रूफ या एविडेंस और ओनली सेल्फ अटेस्टेड कॉपी इज ओके?
नहीं, प्रूफ देना है ना. सपोज इफ इज अ फार्मेसी डिपार्टमेंट, यू हैव अ 52 स्टूडेंट्स यू आर हैविंग इन द डिपार्टमेंट, लेट अस से, है ना.
या या सर,
आउट ऑफ द 52 देयर आर 20 स्टूडेंट्स हैव गॉट द जॉब, लेट अस से, है ना. तो उस डिपार्टमेंट में एक परसेंटेज आपका लेवल में कैलकुलेट कर सकते हैं. एक तो बात ये है, नाउ द आउट ऑफ द 52 स्टूडेंट्स 20 स्टूडेंट्स हैव गॉट द जॉब, सो यू हैव टू गिव द डॉक्यूमेंट्री एविडेंस. वो फार्मास्यूटिकल में गया है, मेडिकल रेप के लिए गया है, अदरवाइज खुद का उन्होंने शॉप ओपन किया है, एंड वेयर दे हैव गॉन दैट यू हैव टू गिव द सम डॉक्यूमेंट्री एविडेंस. वन, they have, suppose if it is a self employed, na, then you give self certification rahega, na. Second, if they have got the through the placement from your institution, then you have to give the agency name and their call letters also you have to give.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Welcome.
Sir, may I ask one question? Sir, myself, Dr. Krug Pasavda. And I am from JS Ayurved College, Adiyad. Our inspection will be due on this current December month. And sir, I am having one question. I want differentiation as you have explained it, but still I want a little bit clarification in the difference between certificate course and value added course, sir.
Okay.
And about evaluation, sir, evaluation process. Like
Madam,
how we can evaluate and give certificate.
ठीक है आप आयुर्वेद का कॉलेज है यू विल कम अंडर द मेडिकल मैनुअल है ना जो मैंने आज जो मैं आज प्रेजेंटेशन किया था वो जनरल कॉलेज के लिए था दैट इज द मार्किंग सिस्टम विच आई हैव मेड है ना
नाउ
देयर आर क्वेश्चंस विल बी डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द मेडिकल मैनुअल टू द जनरल कॉलेज मैनुअल दैट इज वन थिंग सेकंड थिंग इज दैट If at all you are the all the medical colleges, either they come under the Medical Council of India or Dental Council of India or the CCMC. So your institution. Could you just? Kapa, madam, could you just make the mic mute? Echo aa raha hai.
Can you
राजेश महेश्वरी जी
जी सर
आप म्यूट करिए
या डेफिनेटली सॉरी सर
हेलो इको आ रहा है इफ यू डस नॉट अंडर सारी का जो है डॉक्टर कल्पना मैडम
यस सर
सर समबडी इज हैविंग द नॉट अनम्यूटेड दैट इट क्रिएट्स अ प्रॉब्लम
आई थिंक इको इज देयर सर एक्चुअली
Hello. I think now
it is okay. Yes, sir. Please check.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
I have to make a small comment here. The madam which is asked for the Ayurvedic college, we have to look into that question whether it's there or not in the manual. That is one thing. And second thing is that she can raise an issue in the issue management. We will clarify in the portal, through the portal, as the college is undergoing for the accreditation, we will reply to them after looking into the question what she has asked through the manual. Then accordingly we will reply to her. I request the madam to raise in the issue management.
Sir, may I ask question, sir?
Haan, madam.
Sir, I am from law college. And sir, in last year 2019, in the month of June, we have applied IIQA. But sir, we are stuck just because of one concern, that our regulatory body is Bar Council of India. Now, yes, they are, sir, not coming for inspection, and that's why we are not getting affiliation letter for this academic year. Now, my concern is, sir, because we are applying every year, December, that is the period which we have to apply. We are getting the affiliation fees as well. We have the fee receipt. So now that's the case, what we can do it, sir. So can you guide? Because we want move further for this accreditation, sir.
Dr. Rekha, madam, only one thing which I would like to share with you. You have to persuade with the Bar Council of India. Without the recognition, we will not do the assessment, first of all, because it is not you and the me or the NAC. It is the student who is coming out from your institution. So their job, their certificate, their degree should be valid. So for that one, the Bar Council of India has to approve the program.
Sir, actually, they said that we are giving you the receipt. It means that you can continue the process. But if they are not
Let them give in writing saying that it is continued. That one letter is enough.
Okay.
We continue your program. But in the due course, we will do the inspection. Let them give a written letter. That letter is enough.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
But
thank you so much.
There must be some assurance letter from the
BCI.
Bar Council of India.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Welcome.
So we have one more question. Is quantitative metrics data verified during peer visit? We have question.
No.
Is quantitative metrics data verified during peer review?
No. All the quantitative metrics will be validated through the DVV process. When the data validation and verification process happens, after your submission of the self-study report to NAC, within 21 days, the data validation and verification will happen. During that period only, all the quantitative metric will be validated.
Okay. Now we have one more question. Earlier pharmacy colleges were considered under health science, but now it has been considered under general category. Why the format has been changed?
The format has been changed as per the decision of the executive committee of the NAC. So executive committee, there were some colleges have made some representation. Based on the representation made by the different authorities, the authorities have taken a decision that it will be come under the general college.
We have one more question from Mr. Praveen. What method or data is to be expected in COP attainment?
Pharmacy Council of India has made already the program outcome and this program specific outcomes. So those outcomes has to be communicated to the student and the teachers, as well as it should be put on the institutional website. For example, I don't know what is the person who is asked and what subject he is teaching, whether he is teaching the pharmaceutical chemistry, whether he is teaching the pharmacognosy, whether he is teaching in the quality assurance. So accordingly, the subject wise, the paper wise, the course outcomes has to be given. Course means is a paper. Program is a B form is a program. So there every month there will be one or two paper will be there. At the month end, the institution has to validate through the course outcome. At the end semester, it will be the program.
Thank you, sir, for answering the queries. We will be taking up one last question. So any of the participants, if you have any query, one last question we'll be taking up.
Tell me. Sir,
can I ask?
Ha, madam.
Yes.
Under driving a tree, some conditions must be fulfilled while making the functional memory with others.
I'm not audible.
We are.
Ma'am, you are not audible. Ma'am, if possible, can you please write it down into.
Madam, you are able to listen, Dr. Ruby Christian. What was the question?
Sir, sir, actually, she has posted the question, that is, which are the conditions that must be fulfilled while making functional MOU with others under criteria 3.
Okay. Into a chat box, that will be much easier for us to interpret.
Okay. Functional, Dr. Kalpana Patil, madam, the functional MOU means after having an MOU with the particular institution or a particular organization. Okay. Suppose if you are having a with the MOU with the in Lucknow, there is a drug institute is there. So let us say Anand Pharmacy College is having a MOU with the that drug central institution of drugs. That is, let us say, and at least in 1 year, two activities should be conducted. Then only it will be called as the functional MOUs. Functional MOUs means it's not for the sake of the MOU you should have a MOU. But functional MOU means that the communication happens between both parties. So that is called the functional MOUs.
Thank you, sir. Once again, I thank you for such an informative session and for a detailed discussion. We will be now switching over to our next speaker. Thank you.
Dhanyavad, dhanyavad.
Thank you, sir.
Aabhar, aabhar.
Moving on.